count on us for the news you need. 1390 WCSC Charleston.
Here's the latest from ABC News. I'm Deirdre Bryant. With a fanfare, a crowd of well-wishers, and heavy security, Pope John Paul stepped off his jet in Miami. The president and Mrs. Reagan were there to greet the Pope at the start of his 10-day visit. During a welcoming ceremony, the president had special praise.
In Poland, you experienced Nazism and communism. As Pope, you suffered a terrorist attack that nearly claimed your life. Still, you proclaim that the central message of our own time, that the central message of all time is not hatred, but love.
The Pope told the crowd that it was a great joy to be back in America and said he comes with friendship, reverence, and esteem to bring the message of Christ. He concluded his remarks with a prayer for all.
The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. God bless America.
The Pope will visit Catholics in the Little Haiti section of Miami today. He'll meet with President Reagan and with Catholic leaders tonight, and he'll ride in a parade through Miami later tonight. Now this.
Open up a Sears Kenmore refrigerator this week, and you could hear a celebration. It's Kenmore's 60th birthday sale. With extraordinary Kenmore values, our 19.9 cubic foot large capacity refrigerator is just $599.99. You save $230. It's our lowest price ever. Other refrigerators as low as $199. Come celebrate 60 years of Kenmore quality. And save.
There's more for your life.
Sale ends Saturday.
At Sears.
Hey, what's your name?
Sloppy Joe.
I bet that's got something to do with the Sloppy Joe on your shirt.
Uh-oh.
And your shoe.
Whoops.
You need Hamburger Helper Sloppy Joe Bake.
I do?
Yeah, it's the Sloppy Joe that's not sloppy. With a tangy sauce and a tender crust, your mom bakes up fresh.
Sounds neat.
Tastes neat, too. And guess what?
What?
You won't get it on the ceiling.
Hamburger
Helper.
Sloppy Joe Bake.
Criticism is already flying. Secretary of State Schultz told a Senate committee today that the administration plans to ask Congress for $270 million in aid to the Nicaraguan Contras over an 18-month period. The current aid package expires at the end of the month, and Democrats say further aid could endanger the peace plan recently adopted by Central American leaders. A U.S. Navy destroyer had to cancel a port visit to Costa Rica last week. The country demanded proof that all the sailors were free of AIDS. One Navy official says there's a fear and paranoia about AIDS that could threaten U.S. relationships with friendly countries around the world. The fighting continued in the Gulf today as U.N. Secretary General Perez de Cuellar left New York for talks with both Iran and Iraq. Iraqi warplanes bombed Iranian industrial centers today and said it would continue to do so until Iran complies with a U.N. ceasefire. A consumer group has come up with a plan for extending credit to elderly Americans who own their own homes. ABC's Tony Sargent says it will prevent some senior citizens from having to sell their homes to pay for medical emergencies.
The plan lets an elderly homeowner who's paid off most of the mortgage set up a credit line backed by the property value. It's not a lump sum loan. The elderly borrower can make withdrawals to help pay regular living expenses or draw nothing unless big unexpected medical bills or other costs arise. Under the plan, elderly borrowers would be able to stay in their homes no matter how long they might live. They could not outlive their credit line, a big worry among older Americans. This kind of loan is not available yet, but half a dozen states are considering it. Tony Sargent, ABC News, Washington.
Before leaving for Miami this morning, President Reagan paid special tribute to the joint winners of a National Constitution essay writing contest. In a special ceremony, a girl from Portsmouth, Ohio, and a boy from Richland, Washington, were presented with a grand prize of $10,000 each. I'm Deirdre Bryant, ABC News.
CSC News time is 3:04. I'm Kathy Scott. Good afternoon. The woman in charge of the effort to stop abortions during the Pope's visit to Colombia tomorrow disputes statements from abortion clinics that protests will cause patients emotional harm. Lucille O'Keefe of We Will Stand Up claims her group efforts to stop women from entering abortion clinics will actually be helpful.
Although we are trying to prevent these abortions from occurring, that's actually, in our eyes, an act of love because it is a violation of a person's nature to kill another person, and for a mother to kill her child, she's going to figure out what she's done.
Abortion clinic officials call the protests harassment. Columbia Police Chief Robert Wilbur says his officers will be busy with crowd control during the Pope's visit tomorrow, but not so busy the rest of the city will be unprotected.
We will continue to cover the city as we normally do,
because we just can't leave it unprotected, and we will have adequate coverage throughout the city during the time that other activities are taking place.
Wilbur says law enforcement agencies from the Midlands, as well as the Secret Service and Highway Patrol, are working together to make the Pope's visit go smoothly. For those involved, the Pope's visit to Colombia is to be a step toward religious unity, but a group of fundamentalist preachers led by Bob Jones Jr. feels otherwise. The group is running an advertisement in today's issue of the state newspaper condemning Pope John Paul II and the Protestant ministers meeting with him tomorrow. The ad is called an open letter to the Pope. It says in bold print that, quote, Christ is betrayed and the Bible denied by those preachers who welcome you. The ad says that by meeting with the Pope, the Protestant preachers repute those faithful Christian martyrs from your church has done through the ages and imprisoned, tortured, mutilated, and slain. South Carolina Attorney General Travis Medlock says a federal magistrate's recommendation will provide immediate relief to prison overcrowding problems. U.S. Magistrate Charles Gambrill yesterday recommended South Carolina be allowed to relieve prison overcrowding temporarily by putting two inmates in each cell in new prisons for 2 years. The recommendation must still be approved by a U.S. District Court judge. Medlock says the recommendation will help right off the bat by preventing the premature release of prisoners for the next 2 years. CSE News Time is 3:06. Your coastal weather forecast is next.
Oh boy, Joan's mad at me again. She says, I never take her anywhere special. Well, tonight's tonight. I've got reservations for us at the captain's table and the trawler on Shem Creek. We'll dine on the freshest local seafood while the sun sets and the shrimp boats settle in for the night. If you see Joan before then, though, don't tell her about the captain's table and the trawler. See, she thinks we're going to Gus's kitchen for meatloaf night again. Won't she be surprised when we end up at the captain's table and the trawler instead? The captain's table. It just might be the salvation of this love affair.
The Volvo 760 Turbo is a European touring sedan worth waiting for. But now, thanks to increased factory production, you don't have to. In fact, if you visit your Volvo dealer today, you could drive the Volvo 760 Turbo home tomorrow. And since the 760 Turbo engine is intercooled, the trip should be a short one. But it won't be short on comfort. The 760 Turbo is equipped with the luxury features you'd expect to find in a high-performance European touring sedan. Luxuries that include a power sunroof, heated front seats, cruise control, even automatic climate control. For greater control and handling, the 760 Turbo sedan is equipped with stabilizer bars front and rear, anti-lock braking, and a revolutionary suspension system called Constant Track. The Volvo 760 Turbo. Now that you don't have to wait, what are you waiting for? See your Volvo dealer today.
CSC coastal weather, partly cloudy and warm this afternoon with a 30% chance of thunderstorms. Highs 88 along the beaches to 95 inland. Tonight and tomorrow, partly cloudy and warm with a 20% chance of thunderstorms. The low tonight, 72. Tomorrow's high, 85 along the beaches to near 90 inland. The next tide will be low at 4:51 this afternoon. Right now it's 91 degrees in North Charleston and 84 downtown. I'm Kathy Scott, WCSC News. Now more Million Dollar Memories on Charleston's oldie station, 1390 CSC.
Here comes that rainy day feeling again.
Yankees and Toronto Blue Jays, two teams on a mission, collide Saturday in CSC's Major League Game of the Week. The Yanks and Blue Jays have one thing in common. Both trail American League East leading Detroit and are still in contention for the division pennant. This game is crucial to both teams. Join Gene Elston and Jerry Coleman at 1:20 Saturday for all the action as the Yanks and Blue Jays clash on Charleston Sports Center.
WCSC Charleston.
My condition will sing.
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah.
If you like like Motown, stick around. More great hits from the Supremes, the Four Tops, the Temptations, Marvin Gaye, and more from the Motor City are on the way here on Charleston's Oldies Station, 1390 CSE. Way, Roy Orbison, The Turtles, Diana Ross, and more great oldies right here on your memory button, 1390 CSE.
Thursday afternoon it is, as we roll your way on the radio once again on behalf of the new and on the move, West Ashley Toyota, now in our new facility, our new home, Savannah Highway, Charleston, near Citadel Mall. And this Thursday afternoon at West Ashley Toyota, we continue to roll out our remaining 87 Toyota trucks. As a matter of fact, with approved credit this Thursday afternoon at West Ashley, you can buy a brand new Toyota truck for as little as $159 down, $159 a month. Cash price $74.30 plus taxes and tags, 11.25% APR for 60 months. $159 down, $159 a month. That's all it takes at West Ashley Toyota to get a brand new, hard-working Toyota truck. And even at that price, $159 down, $159 a month, your new Toyota truck will come with a bed liner and step bumper that is included with each new Toyota truck sold here at West Ashley Toyota. $159 down, cash or trade, and $159 a month. That's all it takes for a new Toyota truck at the new and on the move West Ashley Toyota, 2100 Savannah Highway, Charleston, near Citadel Mall.
WCSC Charleston.
Middle of more million-dollar memories from
WCSC Charleston.
I'm Kathy Scott with the 1390 CSC News Minute. Reagan administration sources say Defense Secretary Caspar Weinberger will visit the Persian Gulf later this month. The sources say he'll see U.S. military personnel in the region and will talk with officials in at least two countries about their support of the Navy's Middle East Task Force. The countries are Saudi Arabia, where U.S. surveillance planes are based, and Beirut, where there's a small naval support base. Iranians who oppose Ayatollah Khomeini's regime made their presence felt today in Norway, France, and West Germany. In Norway, the National News Agency said 11 unarmed men occupied Iran's embassy for more than 2 hours before surrendering and being taken to police headquarters. In West Germany, 8 people briefly occupied an Iran air office. And in France, protesters shattered windows of an Iran air office. Former 6th District Congressman John Jenrette is ready to return to politics. Jenrette lost his seat in 1980 when he was charged in the Amscam bribery scandal, but yesterday the Democrat apologized for his actions in comments to the Surfside Beach Rotary Club. Before the meeting, Jenrette said he is awaiting the results of a poll to decide whether he will seek the Democratic nomination. CSC coastal weather, partly cloudy and warm this afternoon with a 30% chance of thunderstorms. Highs 88 along the beaches to 95 inland. The next tide will be low at 4:51 this afternoon. And right now it's 91 degrees in North Charleston and 84 downtown. From the CSC News Center, I'm Kathy Scott.
I'm going to McElveen Crossroads. McElveen Crossroads, here I come.
It's goodbye, 87 closeout time at Charlie's Place, McElveen, Pontiac, Buick, GMC, and Somerville. And old Charlie saved the best to last. 1.9% financing and cash rebates to $1,000 on over 200 of the most popular cars in America, including GM's hot sports cars, the Trans Am GTA 350 V8, and the mid-engine Fiero GT. Just pick your car or your truck and then pick your payment. McElveen delivers it at closeout 87 prices. And till they're gone, no reasonable offer will be refused. It's a buyer's market today at McElveen Crossroads in Somerville. Come on out.
You know they're South Carolina's largest, so I know I'm gonna find me one. Well, they've got a lot of hot new cars and trucks, and I've just got to have me one.
McElveen Crossroads, I-26 and 70A in Somerville.
Charleston's best memories. Charleston's best oldies. It's all right here on 1390 CSC.
Here at West Ashley Toyota this Thursday afternoon, we are excited. We continue to move out our remaining 87s at West Ashley Toyota. Now, a little earlier here on the radio, we were talking about our lineup of new Toyota trucks. This time around, one of the most popular cars Toyota has ever produced, the Toyota Corolla. And we've got a good selection at West Ashley Toyota. Over 36 Corollas in stock right now. And with approved credit this Thursday afternoon, you can buy a new Corolla from West Ashley for as little as $179 down, $179 a month. Cash price, $83.64 plus taxes and tags, 1.25% APR for 60 months. $179 down, $179 a month is all it takes at West Ashley to buy a new Toyota Corolla, the kind of a deal you can do. This Thursday afternoon, I mentioned over 36 in stock. We have several of them available for $179 down, $179 a month. New Toyota Corolla from West Ashley Toyota. Want to remind you, all of our cars and trucks prepped and ready for immediate delivery here at the dealership. Finance men on duty for quick credit approval. The new and on the move, West Ashley Toyota, 2100 Savannah Highway, Charleston, near Citadel Mall.
Jerry, what are we doing at a Farmore grand opening?
I want to check out their great prices.
Well, their prices can't be that great. Let's go golf.
Listen, I'll be back just in a second.
Oh, yeah, the dumbest thing I ever... Oh, my gosh!
Norm, what is it?
Look at the low price on this shampoo!
Norm, shh!
You know what I paid for it?
At Farmore, you can save up to 50%.
This must be 50% less. Is this just for the grand opening?
No, Farmore has great prices to housewares, cosmetics, all kinds of stuff every day.
How do you guys do it?
Norm, something called power buying. Farmer only buys when they get a terrific deal.
Yeah?
Then they buy in tremendous quantities and pass the savings on to us. That gives us buying power.
Oh, my gosh.
Norm, would you just...
Look at these pantyhose. You know what Myrna pays for these pantyhose?
Norm.
What?
You're embarrassing me.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jerry.
Okay, I'll just get my stuff and then we can leave.
I'm never leaving.
What?
Oh, my God!
Discover how Farmore's power buying gives you far more buying power.
Shop the grand opening of the new Farmore's at New North Rivers Market across from Northwoods Mall and the West Ashley Shops across from Citadel Mall.
WCSC 1390, count on us.
If you like beach music, you're going to love us. Stick around for all the beach music hits right here on 1390 CSC, Charleston's oldie station.